Hey Lulas. So sometimes we get so caught up in the drama and what's going on, who's scamming who, who's getting over who, who's charging too much, who's charging too less. We get into all the other dramas and we kind of lose sight of the fun parts of the hobby. And that's what I have been enjoying lately, is just really, really enjoying that part of the hobby. So right now you're looking at Prototype Aspen. This is Aspen by Claire Teller. And this one was actually painted and rooted by Sylvia from Sylvia's Creation. Sylvia Esquire, I don't know how to pronounce her last name, but from Sylvia Creation. And I just had to have her. So she did, we were the two prototype artists for Claire Teller with this kit edition. And it was just, you know, it was just so nice to see the two different versions of the babies. So I was really happy to snag her. So I'm gonna get her dressed, but what I was gonna say, the fun part about the hobby is, all this weekend. The fun part about the hobby is when you can have so many people paint the same kit and they look so different. So different to the point where people start questioning, is that the same kit? Are they the same size? Because it's so many factors that go into these babies. When I used to collect a while back, I got a few small babies. Like, they were like more preemie, but I wanted the babies to be able to wear clothes out of, like, you know, regular newborn clothes. So what some of the artists used to do is they would put the babies on longer bodies. So say it was a 17 inch baby or a 15 inch baby, this is her legs. They would put them on, like, it was 15 inch baby, they would put them on like an 18 inch body, and it would make them be able to fit into newborn size clothes. Sometime, you know, they just would switch out the bodies and make them look bigger or longer. So it's so many things play a role in it. And a lot of these artists, when they're making the babies, they look at the babies and they make the adjustments that they want to make to the baby. And it can change the size of the baby. So when people say, what size do so-and-so kit wear? It's like, yeah, you could say that, but it just depends on how the baby is put together. Some babies are, I didn't know you guys couldn't see. Some babies are actually weighted differently, like they're like stuffed to be fatter. Some are like understuffed to be floppier or whatever. It's just so many things. Then there's the painting. The painting definitely will change a baby so much. Like I said, London seems to be more of my serene version of the sculpt. My Aspen seemed to be like a baby being a little disturbed in his sleep. Like that somebody's, he's stirring, he's getting ready to wake up. So he's kind of like, eh, like, don't wake me up. Type thing. It's just funny. Even Aspen, the sculpt, even with her, sometimes she even looked like she could be even a little bit Asian. So it's really cool. I really, really love that about the hobby, that I can see so many different versions of one sculpt. I think that, you know, I know not to add any drama to the video, But I have seen artists that look at other people's work and then they decide that they like it so much that they want to paint like them. And then they kind of take on the other artist's style of painting. And for me, it's kind of like stolen identity, if that makes sense. Or it just, for me, it's not the fun part. I don't like that part, because sometimes we think that we're not good enough and we want to do better, and that's fine. We should always continue to try to grow. But when you try to be just like somebody, like a carbon copy, you become just that, a copy, and it waters down, you know, your work to a certain extent. I feel like when people are at their best and being creative in their own way, we get something so much beautiful. Even if it's not perfect, it's a part of you and your creativity. This dress is wrinkly. I should have ironed it. Yeah, we're gonna probably have to take this off and then redo it, but I just want to see if she can fit it. But yeah, so that's just my thought process. A lot of people ask me like what I think about this or what I think about that. I think I like, yes, I can't do this with this collar. We're not gonna make it. I think that artists should definitely just be who they are and embrace that. So she was gonna have like her little lovey and her little, yeah, not gonna work. Okay, so let's take that off of her. Me and a friend was just talking about this the other day about babies, small babies and dresses. They have to be the right dress on them. It doesn't look good. So this would probably look good on a baby more like 0 to 3 months. Not newborn. She's a very newborn baby. So, say, Mama, you're messing up my hair. Whoa, whoa, whoa. It's good. It lays right back down into place. But, don't worry. I came with a backup. And a backup to the backup. Which means this is going to be even more big on her. But anyway, yeah, so I just love seeing the different styles, artist styles and stuff like that, and that's what I actually enjoy collecting for my personal collection. And I like when artists like kind of like paint according to the kit. Like some artists like will paint every single baby the exact same way, no matter the age. Like a toddler baby might not be as model as a newborn baby, but and vice versa. But people will just, all the babies are painted all the same skin tone, same markings in the same place every time. It's nice when they kind of switch it up, but you know what, if it works for you, it works for you. You gotta do what works for you. But I am enjoying seeing so many different versions of different babies. So when the Aspens come out, I can't wait. I already got my mind set to be like, okay, you definitely gonna have to be on your A game with not trying to buy every Aspen, because I know some of these artists out here are going to paint the heck out of this baby. We don't hardly get babies with full lips that the features are not overly done. Oh, look at your little belly plate. Oh my goodness, girl. So that their features are not overly done. So it's gonna be nice. And girl, this diaper is done had it. That's the problem. She done had it on for so long because I like them in the white diapers, but I don't think I have a white diaper in here. I'm gonna change her diaper. Let me pull this down because I look a little weird. But yeah, I keep saying I don't, like, it's so funny because, like, soon as people see, a baby painted, like, AA, or if they see a baby painted, or a baby sculpted with fuller lips, they assume that it was sculpted from a black baby, or something like that, and that's not always the case. It's like, or they think that it has to be painted very dark skin with nappy hair. It's just a whole misconception of, I don't know, like, you know, I'm okay with embracing our more coarse hair and our full lips and broader nose, but there's different features and bone structure and all this jazz that actually goes along with all of that. So it's not just about throwing a big nose on a sculpt and big lips. It's just more than that. And there's a difference. There's full lips, and then there's big lips, and then there's just like features that may be true to some African Americans, but just not the most common, because we have been tampered with so much over time that a lot of those strong features that we had are watered down in these generations because we are no longer pure in pure form. We're all mixed up with something. Because back in slavery, the women were raped so much and sold and, you know, all that stuff. So they had babies from their slave masters, and it trickled down to our children, our grandchildren, and then the great-grandchildren. And so that's why some of us don't quite have all the features, because our generation has been tampered with. A lot of times when you go to places like Nigeria and places like that, and don't get me into history because I don't really know all that much, but I do know that from what I see, they're usually a little bit more pure than African American people, if you want to call them such, because we've been so tampered with, those features aren't as common as one would think. That's just my thought process. Here's Sugar Boogoo. All right. So I'm going to stop here because I've went into too much, and I'm probably going to have to actually put this in the Chatterbox because it's probably too much for the mainstream channel. But yeah, so that's my thought process. I just really think that I enjoy the different sculpts. I enjoy the babies. I enjoy how you could take a very Caucasian sculpted baby, portrait baby, and make it look very African American, and how you can take an African American sculpted portrait and make it look very Caucasian. I love that you can do all the different skin tones, or, you know, Asian, and you can just by changing the hair and the skin tone and just highlighting certain features can give you such a different look. I love that. I love that about the art, and I think it get lost in everything else that goes on with the hobby, and we don't talk about it or enjoy it like, you know, like we should be enjoying it, because it's the best part of the hobby to be able to have a unique baby. So yeah, I'm gonna go cut this off so I can make a video with her on the gym pop, because I didn't mean to get into all of that. So I'm gonna drop this one here.